example, when you come and ask, I should win a lottery 1 crore. You are very clear, you will come next time and tell me that it's not happened. So with that mental setup he becomes, what he really is asking, what I am asking should not happen. So I say, tadastu, let it be, and it will not happen. Understand, sometime you use, these are all very subtle points, this is one of the important catching point. Many fellows, they use their seeking to constantly prove to themselves the system is wrong.
By system is wrong, what does...
Means, I did what Swamiji said but did not work out. I did what scriptures say, it did not work out. So we start using our passion for that.
What
so but naturally it means the passion is not complete. Use your passion to align your actions towards the passion. And you will just see the things are happening. If it is not happening, question your passion, not anything else. That is why I say passions. The mindset questioning all other things needs passions. The mindset which is aligning your actions need passion. You have two mindsets. Usually we always do the opposite. We use the passion to question everything else. Use passions to align your action into the passion. All of you understand what I am saying? Exactly the point. I think I got the thread. You understand what I am saying? I think this point, even in the discourse, I didn't express. Usually, whenever people come and ask me, I am really passionate, but thing is not happening, means they are using their passion to question the system, not to align their actions, which is supposed to be the opposite. Use the passion to align your actions towards that passion. And the mind which constantly questions the system, have passions for that part. You have two part. So one part needs patience, which is constantly questioning everything else. One part needs passion, which is aligning all your actions and the whole process towards the system. And we do usually opposite. Chala, come on.
Your satsang on vitarka, kutarka, vitarka and tarka.
Tarka, kutarka, vitarka.
That helped quite a bit because I could find that...
Let me tell you, actually when a man as a vitarka, I see very clearly between me and him like a tunnel of energy. When he comes near me, I know that like a tunnel of energy will be there between him and me. Like a bridge. So when I give, let it happen in you, like a, just like a ball, the energy flows into him. That whenever a person with vidarka comes around me, it was such a joy to be around that person. It was just joy to be around the person. See, in my whole drama, in my whole leela, you all enjoy my shakti. I enjoy your bhakti. That's the whole leela. And that's why the whole leela happens. Whenever the person with... See, vidarka means having the breadth, broad logic which accommodates and ready to accept even the things which are not taught to you in the school. You understand? That's a clear definition. The school is not the place of perfect education. Do not think you know about some subject if you have a postdoctorate degree.
School is not actually...
There is something...
School is actually not a place of education, I would say.
So, that is the definition of vidarka. School and the society is not the place to give you the complete education. The vidarka is like opening a new channel. Understand? It's like you have a TV, you have only 7 channels, And if suddenly some new connection is given, you have 100 channel. Vidarka is like that. When I say the devatas, celestial beings are here, I am not lying. You understand? Just I am seeing they are all here with the same excitement which you guys are having. When, what will happen, who is going to achieve what? They are also just hanging around. Really. But what to do? Guys with the vidarka can straight away catch. Yes, he is right. When she said, it's like Kailash, it's not she is praising. And please be very clear. Innocent faith is not writing. Intelligent faith. Innocent faith, please be very clear. Ignorance cannot be forgiven just because you give the title innocence to it. Many times, our ignorance, we label it. If somebody else is innocent, he is ignorant. If we are ignorant, it is innocence.
But faith should be blind or?
Huh?
The faith is always blind, isn't that?
Faith is intelligence. Gopis had such a strong faith on Krishna because of their intelligence. They are vidarka. So the faith based on darka is not complete. It can be broken at any time. If it can be broken, it is faith based on darka, not vidarka. On kudarka, faith never grows. And faith based on darka only can be broken. It must be ignorant faith, not innocent faith. Ignorant faith is always dangerous, not only for you, for me also. I don't accept that ignorant faith guys around me. All the people whom I pick up and keep around me, they are intelligent faith.
From one of your discourse, you mentioned that if you have a doubt, surrender it to me. If you have a faith, surrender it to me.
Then the vidarka faith will happen.
Thank you, Swamiji.
You internalize that and start putting questions. Many of the pins can be removed. Many pins can be removed just with that one vidarka. I can say that was one of the important breakthrough message from me. Nowhere you will find that definition. Understand? When Narada curses, it happens. When Brahma gives boon, it happens. In our tradition, we read thousands of stories. Even a chaste wife, when she gives a boon, it happens. When she curses, it happens. Savitri, she can just stop son. Ordinary girl. She says, hey, don't raise. It is not raising. How come? Why all those things are not lifestyle now? Today somebody was asking, when the Vedic lifestyle was taken away from the masses? Today I was answering the question. When the Vidarka was disconnected, that was the time when the Vedic lifestyle is not part of mass. Even when you guys go and tell outside, there is a small boy, we are 32 years old and we were sitting at his feet for 3 months. They will laugh at you. Because many of you guys are 10 times more educated than me. And surely, many are, if you are elders, not only elders, many of you are my grandfather's age and almost 90% of you are my father's age. And if you guys go out and tell, 3 months you are sitting at his feet. And this fellow, whatever he was telling, you guys are doing. What's going on? So the Vidarka channel opened. So Vedic tradition was taken away from mass when Vidarka channel was closed. When that Vidarka transmission was broken, it was very systematically broken. Few thousand years ago. Understand? When we started thinking, I think Ramayana is not exactly as it happened. I think Mahabharata is only a mythological story. Vidarka was lost. please be very clear. Everything Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhagavata, literally true. There was a war with atomic weapon. Understand? Now all the scientific atomic weapon, flight, everything is based on light waves. Everything is electricity, light waves. The Vedic tradition was using all these things same way, based on sound waves, mantra. The whole cosmos is sound waves and light waves. The science is light wave based. They were able to reproduce it without the help of the mind. The light wave based things does not need the cooperation of your mind. But the sound wave based things need the cooperation of your mind. So that is why this was lost. Otherwise we had flight, atomic weapons, train, whatever you call as a gift of the science we had. But the whole thing was based on the sound wave technology. That was based on, now the whole thing, whatever science is all based on the light wave technology. Means electronics, electrical and electronics. The whole thing is light wave based technology. You are able to relate with what I am saying? This whole thing is sound wave based technology. That is why, see, the sound wave based technology needs a person's mind also to be in tune. You see, when Ravana had the Pushpaka Vimana, it was a sound wave based technology. He sits and utters few words and it lifts, creates some sound and it flies. Now, if a pilot sits and sends electronic signals, the electrical energy, the light wave energy to some parts, it picks up and it flies. Same way, when Ravana sits, maybe he has to put his hand on some part and create a light wave, the sound wave. Om Shanno Mitra Shamvarunaha Shanno Bhavat Varyama Shanna Indro Brihaspatihi. Flight will pick up. That waves reaches through the system and it picks up. And he maintains some sound. Reem, 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 that wave, it moves. The whole thing was sound wave based technology. For this to be constantly reproduced and to operate, that knowledge needs the cooperation of the mind. So these guys took care very clearly, the next generation mind does not cooperate with the technology. So the whole infrastructure is waste. The whole infrastructure is waste. That is what happened exactly. Now, suddenly if the science of sending electrical signals, the light wave into the flight, if it is lost, the whole infrastructure, all the airports all over the world, all the aircrafts built is waste. And you say, no, people are telling lie, there was a time when the aircraft was flying. Suddenly they say, no, there was never a time aircrafts were flying. That is what now these guys are telling, there was never a time where Pushpaka Vimana was flying. It was. I know experientially. Suddenly realize, you see, the Brahmastra, which Arjuna had, sound wave based. He takes it and utters those sound waves, charges it and leaves. It just goes and explodes as atomic bomb. The atom bomb, sound wave based, not uranium based. Uranium based means electrical. The light wave based. This is sound wave based. The whole thing is, that's all. The light wave based does not need your cooperation. But the sound wave, light wave, I can say in this way, light wave based, your logic cooperation is enough. So the whole civilization of light wave based is logic based. And developing logic. Pilot needs to be taught how to move, this, that, everything. Logic based, reproducible without the development of the heart or the being. But our system was reproducible only with a developed beings, because developed beings was lifestyle for us. Any being born, brought up in the tradition by the age of 14 is a developed being. So we don't have to have a separate structure to create developed beings. So it was systematically broken. First the developed being system, how to create the developed beings, stop that, eradicate that. Then stop the technology. Then the whole infrastructure is waste. Otherwise, why do you think such huge temples all over the country? Do you know, in this country, we have 1 crore temples and ashrams. Our whole population is only 1.2 billion, means 120 crore. It means each 120 person has one temple or the ashram. And the swamis and the preachers who dedicated their whole life to the to protect this, to live this dharma, 1 crore people. I am not talking about the people who don't have address, the swamis who are wandering in the streets and begging and eating, sleeping under the trees. No, addressed, who has address, track record, back the backing documentation, who he is. That kind of swamis, 1 crore. Of course, when I say swami, swamis, priests, everything put together, 1 crore. Means the technology was true, and it is taken away from the mass, that's all. Otherwise, Brahmastra was there, everything was there. It was all clear technology. And one more thing, if the Mahabharata can be imagined by some brain so systematically, 1 lakh slokas, couplets, any of you have read that book? In original, 1 lakh couplet, still now that is the largest poem written on the planet Earth. 1 lakh couplet, and it is very clear from first to last, one guy wrote, because the language flow, the slang which he is using, only one guy wrote. If one fellow can write 1 lakh couplet in his life by imagining, he must be God, a little more than God. Try to see one movie script and how these fellows are struggling and cheating and stealing from everywhere. One movie script. 1 lakh couplet, when the brain was 1/3 as per the scientists. Few thousand years ago, that's what they say. It was 1/3. When the brain was 1/3 as per the scientists, 100,000 couplets, a single guy can imagine such a thriller story. Still it is a thriller for me, understand? Still it is a thriller for me. When I look at Mahabharata and Ramayana, still tears are in my eyes are watery. Still it is a thriller. The other day, I was traveling in Chennai, maybe 3 months before. In Ramayana is being played in one of the major channels. So much of publicity. Now, still, after so many, I don't know still who doesn't know Ramayana in India. But still, it's a thriller. So, if somebody can compose, it's not a lie. It happened, maybe I can say poetically described.
So I was told that the Mahabharata war was started between a clan of 5 brothers and 100.
Can you be a little loud? Bye.
Between 5 brothers.
Yes, yes, yes.
And
5 brothers and 100 brothers.
And 100.
It was a fight for the land and the pride.
But what created this strife if they were living, following the Vedic tradition?
No, you see, understand. Vedic tradition does not mean everybody is enlightened. It gives the option for enlightenment. In the 100, it's not that all these guys are enlightened. They were developed beings. All pilots are not enlightened. Same way, all the fellows who are able to handle that sound wave energy is not enlightened. Developed beings, but not enlightened beings. Ramayana was war for women, Ramayana is a war for women. You know Ramayana? You ever read Ramayana? No. It's a Rama story. When a master initiates disciples, he makes the commitment, promise. You would have heard that till you became me, the super conscious, the ultimate highest experience, I'll continue to help you and guide you, be with you, whether you leave the body or I leave the body. When I make this commitment to, for example, 2 lakh people, I make this commitment. So in the 2 lakh, all 2 lakh may not have become enlightened in next 100 years. So some buffaloes will be there. So what to do? Even if I leave the body, I should be available for their call. So that kind of masters only will be in Shambhala with that form retaining. Others will just disappear into the cosmos.